Hello, love bugs, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, I'm Sarah, and I help teach people how to find inner happiness through fitness and spirituality. And today, we're gonna talk about how to gain more confidence, be more in your power, super, super easily by just doing these few things. So if you're ready, let's get into it. Really, what we're going to be talking about today is words that you're most likely using in your vocabulary that are disempowering you, making you feel less confident and more not in your power. And it's really simple, although you'll have to kind of be weary about when you use them and just have that awareness, and you kind of have to like realize it, stop yourself in the moment, and like switch the wording. So the first word I want to talk about is the word sorry. So most of us really overuse this word at a very high magnitude, and a lot of times you can replace that word with a more positive direction that helps you keep your confidence and also doesn't make you seem weak to whoever you're apologizing to. Now, disclaimer, if you're actually sorry about something and you want that to be known, yes, please use that word. But an example I could think of would be, you know, oh, you're running a little late to something and you show up and you're like, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry I'm late. And it kind of sets the tone on a more negative note. So instead of saying, hey, sorry I'm late, you want to say something more like, hey, thank you so much for your waiting for me, or thank you so much for your time. And that more so levels the playing field and doesn't make you feel like you're lesser than the other person. Another word that you want to remove is just. Like, I just wanted to do this, or I just wanted to say this. It's such a minimalizing word where if you just remove that word, instead of saying like, I just think that blah, 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 I think that. Like, it's just totally an unnecessary word. I do it myself. And what it does is just minimalize what you're trying to say. And it's something that especially women, although I think everyone does it, really we're trained to do that, to almost like make yourself smaller and belittle yourself and belittle whatever it is that you're trying to say. And you really just don't need to do that. Another example would be, I was wondering if. Again, that's such a minimalizing word. Like, oh, I was just wondering if blah, 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 blah. Like, for example, if you wanted to see someone, you could say, you know, I was just wondering if maybe you wanted to, you know, hang out. No, 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 no. I wanted to know if you'd like to hang out, blah, 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 blah. Do you see the difference of that? And the thing is when you say words like this, you do take a different tone in your voice. I was wondering if, oh, I was kind of wondering if, I would like to take you for coffee. Yeah. How does blah, 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 blah sound? Either way, if you use those words or if you don't, the other person's answer is most likely going to be the same. But people are attracted to confidence. They're attracted to not minimalizing yourself. They're attracted to people that walk into the room and say what they really mean and mean what they say. So don't belittle yourself. Don't say things like, oh, I was wondering if, or oh, I'm so sorry that, da, 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 da. No, 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 no. Step into your power. You are a powerful human being. You do not need to belittle, and you do not need to minimize yourself for others to feel better around you. If anything, you're actually doing the opposite. This next one is probably the one I'm most passionate about, and that's saying I can't and switching it with I won't. So an example I could tell you is, back when I used to sell cars, we had a vending machine in the dealership. And of course, we all know vending machines in the USA, they're not healthy. So someone would say, hey Sarah, do you want, you know, this? And I would find myself saying, oh, you know, if I was dieting, like, no, I can't. And then I would immediately like, I won't. And it's so much more empowering saying, oh, I can't have that piece of chocolate. I won't have that piece of chocolate. I am choosing not to have that piece of chocolate. Do you see the difference there? Like, it is just so these words, like words make up our lives. Words make up who we are and how others perceive us and how we perceive ourselves. So if you make these little tweaks in your vocabulary, it is literally going to change your entire life, I promise. Another kind of slew of words that I'd like to mention here are, I'll try to do something, or I wish, or I hope. All of those things are essentially putting out into the universe and reprogramming your mind that you want to do something, but you're essentially making yourself more comfortable by using those words like try or wish or hope, and remove them. You're not going to try to lose weight. You're going to lose weight.
Yeah.
You're not going to wish for more money. You're going to work and you're going to get more money. Can't say it enough. I'm so passionate about this kind of stuff, especially because I do have a degree in broadcast journalism. So I have literally studied words and the differences they can make in the order you put them in the tone that you say them in, and you just, I did it. So you see, you kind of have to catch yourself in the moment, and I want you guys to understand how potent and how important words are, because you're reprogramming your mind. If you're saying things like, I am something negative, I am fat, I am lazy, I am too blah 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 to accomplish X, Y, and Z, you are putting that into your brain, you are putting that into your subconscious. And as we've talked about in Law of Attraction videos before, if you're putting that out into the universe, that's what you're getting back. So if you're saying, I'm too fat, the universe is gonna throw things at you, confirmation bias, that you are too fat for X, Y, and Z, or that you can't lose weight, or that you won't do this. You can do these things, you just have to tweak these little tiny things in your vocabulary. And the last words I want to run by you guys, I'm sure you've heard this before, but that is always and never. Again, those are going into your head. So if you say, I could never lose 50 pounds, or I could never look good in that dress, or I could never be with that person, then you're right. You know, you are telling yourself that and you are believing it. The more you say it, the more you believe it. So the more you catch yourself and you start changing those words, you are reprogramming your mind to know that, to attract that. And I promise, if you make these tiny little switches and you bring these awarenesses to your vocabulary, it will change. It will change everything you believe. It will change your life. Like, think about this. What if I was sitting here filming this video and I'm saying, well, you should try to change this and you should try to do this and I think that maybe you could do it, or I hope that, you know, you can do whatever your mind is. Instead of saying, bitch, you got this, you can do this, I know you can, and you will do it. Do you see the way that I come off differently? I mean, I know I can be a little aggressive. Please like and subscribe to this video. Or what if I said, I really hope you guys would choose to subscribe, or I really wish that you would like this video. Like, no! Have confidence. You got this. You have it, and the only one that has control over what you believe is you. If you have someone else saying things, shut them out, because if you start to reprogram your mind and you start to truly believe that you can and you will do things, it won't matter what other people say. It won't matter what other people think about you, because you will be reprogramming your mind to believe in yourself and believe that you can do it and believe that you have the confidence and that you can. And it's not something that's going to change overnight. It's not like today you're gonna do this and you're gonna have that awareness. You're still gonna slip up. I mean, you guys saw earlier in the video, I slipped, I said just, and then I caught myself. And the more you catch yourself, the more you have that awareness, the more often you'll catch yourself. And soon, you'll train your mind to not even have these words come through, or to not believe them once they come through. When I was at the dealership and I would say these things, oh, I can't have that, immediately I'd say, I won't have that. I'm choosing not to have that. And I believe that, and so it's a lot easier to achieve what you're looking for or what you want when you're removing these words from your vocabulary. So I hope you guys learned a lot in this video. It's a very simple thing that you can do to really change the dynamic of your life, to really change your confidence and to step into your power, because you, my friend, are a powerful human being. We all are. I love you guys so much. Don't forget to like and subscribe this video, and don't forget, be limitlessly yourself.